Hello and welcome to another Point Blank Deconstruction with our in-house legend, Ski Oakenfull. This time, Ski will be deconstructing God's Plan by Drake. Keep in mind, the original song is pitched, so it's between two keys. Ski has pitched it up 48 cents to conform to B flat minor. Anyways, enjoy.
Hi everyone, Ski Oakenfull here. In this video, I'm going to be breaking down this track by Drake called God's Plan. Huge track, came out in 2018, and I'm going to be using Ableton Live 10 Suite together with Push 2. So let's start off by programming the beat. I've got some drum sounds that I prepared. Kick drum, rim, clap, triangle, closed hi-hat, castanet, and 808 cowbell. So got record quantize on, and I'm going to set the quantize to 16ths. Put the metronome on, got the accent on as well. So let's start putting it in. There we go. So we can take the metronome off now. And now I'm going to put in the closed hi-hat, and for this I'm just going to put the repeat on, playing 16ths. There we go. Take the repeat off, and we can put in this triangle sound now. And then we're going to put in this 808 sound. And there's one more sound left, which is this castanet sound. And this is a faster rhythm. I'm actually going to change the quantize back to 32. So let's put this in. Here we go. So there we go, we've got our basic beat. Now I'm going to build up three main sections here. So I'm just going to go to the session view, and I'm just going to duplicate that beat down to the second scene there. And all I'm going to do is just take out the kick drum. So we've got two scenes. Great. So the next part I'm going to put down is this organ sound. And before I put it in, let's have a little look at the music theory behind this track. So the key signature of this track is B flat minor. And if I play the scale of B flat natural minor, we have this. We have five flats, B flat, D flat, E flat, G flat, and A flat. Now this track is made up of two main chords, B flat minor 7 and C minor 7. An interesting thing is that in the chord of C minor 7, we have this note here, which is a G natural, and not the G flat that's in the B flat natural minor. So what we can deduce is that the scale being used is actually the B flat Dorian, where we actually raise the sixth note, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This G flat is actually playing a G. So this is the scale. So just going back to the chords, we have B flat minor 7 and C minor 7. And actually underneath, there's some slight variation in the bass notes where we have this. Just gives it a little bit of an extra movement. And one final thing to note is that actually when we put the bass line in, you'll see that it actually ends up on the F. So for the last chord, we have C minor 7 over F. But we'll come to that in a minute. So I'm going to just get rid of the keyboard now, And let's just try putting this in on push. So I'm going to use the scale mode here, and you can see I've got B flat Dorian. And that means that all the notes I'm playing are the notes from B flat Dorian. So let's just put in this bottom part first. And I can play the chord here. So let's just play that over the top. Just check the quantizer's on. Yeah, it is. So there we go. Brilliant. So now just going back to session view, I'm just going to duplicate that down to the three scenes. Great. So the next sound is the bass. And just quickly going back to the keyboard, we're just playing the tonic, which is B flat, up to the C, back to the B flat, and then finishing on the F. So let's just put that in. There we go. Great, so I'm just going to go to session view now, and I'm just going to duplicate that part down to the second scene. And actually for the third scene, there's a slightly different bass line. It's an ascending bass line. Let's just have a quick look to see what it's doing on the keyboard. It's just going up, starting on the tonic, B flat, C, D flat, up to the F. So let's put that in on push. So going to the next sound now, this is a lead sound, and this is a really nice subtle sound that kind of sits underneath, and this comes in this second scene here. So let's just have a quick look at the notes that are being played. Let's just play along. Great, so let's put that in on push. And for this, I'm actually going to take the record quantize off just to make it a little bit freer. Great, let's just adjust this note slightly. There we go. Okay, and for the third scene, there's a slight variation. Let's put it in. So it'd be really great to hear this with the a cappella, and I managed to find this on the internet. Someone had used some kind of phase reversal to extract the vocal. So I've prepared this. So I'm just going to drag these clips onto this channel here. And let's have a listen to what that sounds like. I don't want to die for them to miss me. Yes, I see the things that they wishing on me. Hope I got some brothers that outlive me. They gon' tell the story, shit was different with me. Might go down to G-O-D, yeah. I go hard on Southside G, yeah. I make sure that Northside E. we go. So I hope you enjoyed that. And before I go, I just wanted to quickly mention a few of the sounds that I've been using here. So for this drum rack, just wanted to show you this kick. This is actually a layered kick sound, and it's a combination of two sounds. We've got a sample. It's actually from one of the Ableton packs, and I've taken all the bottom end off that. And then we've got this one, which is one of the Max for Live drum synth sounds. Let's just go back onto that. There we go. So combination of the two. Sounds really nice. For the organ sound, I'm using the Native Instruments Contact 5 organ. There we go. And I tweaked this preset and tried to get as close as I could to the original sound. Then we have this bass, sub-bass sound. And this is a sound I actually made a few years ago for a previous video, a Julio Bashmore video, which you should be able to download. And then for this lead synth sound, this is just a lead analog sound that I made. That's on its own. I used the new Live 10 pedal plugin, the distortion on that, and then some chorus to widen it out. So there we go. Hope you enjoyed that. Catch you again very soon.